Hey everybody, I wanted to give you one more video about Minitab. In this one, I was going to show you an Excel spreadsheet that I'll provide that just helps pick hypothesis tests. Wanted to orientate you to it real quick. Anything in red is a graph, anything in blue is a hypothesis test. And then when I do hypothesis testing, to me it's pretty easy. It's always based on data type. And there's usually a buzzword associated with the data type. So, for example, if your Y is continuous, such as weight, and your X is discrete, male, female, that puts you in this corner. And then these are all the hypothesis tests you can do. But more importantly, the buzzword is average, medians, and variation. So I put a hyperlink in there. If you just click to it, it takes you to where in Minitab you could do that. So you would go to Assistant, Hypothesis Tests, and then just follow this roadmap. So if I go back to the beginning, I want to know if my speed at which I drive my car to work predicts, there's the buzzword predictor, how long it takes me to get to work. Well, I have a continuous Y, continuous X, I can do scatter plots, regression, again, scatter plots. All the graphs are located under the Assistant in Minitab. And again, there's the buzzword. So, with that, I thought I would just do some quick hypothesis testing. As you saw earlier, let me go back. It told me I want to compare my Y is continuous, it's sales, and my X is discrete, it's ad agency. So I come here. The buzzwords are average, medians, and variation. So it tells me to go to Assistant Hypothesis Test to compare averages and standard deviations, or I could go down here if I want to compare medians. So in this quick example, I just want to compare the average of sales with our old ad agency and our new one, Alpha and Omega. So I'm just going to go, it tells me to go Assistant Hypothesis Tests, and then just follow this roadmap is what my Excel spreadsheet said. We have two X's. And they are independent of each other. So I'm going to do the two sample t-test. That's going to compare average sales. Now, Minitab allows you to work on what they call stacked or unstacked data. So in this example, the data is stacked, meaning the two X's are on top of each other. Again, this is not a Minitab course. I just wanted to make you familiar with it since most companies doing Lean Six Sigma use this software. And I'm going to do ad agency. And I just want to know if they're different. And the answer is yes. Do the means differ at a p-value less than 0.05? Alpha was getting us 287. Omega's getting us 399. All right, in this example, I want to know if how much we spend on advertising predicts sales. So if you recall, I go back to here, the buzzword is predictor, two continuous variables. If I click, it tells me to go to assistant regression and use the assistant if I have less than five X's. So I will do that. I will go assistant regression. And I just have one Y, one X. So I'm going to go here. The Y is sales, and what I want to see if it predicts is advertising, which would make sense. You would think the more you'd spend on advertising, the more sales you would get, or do you? So let's see. Looks like a very weak relationship. The R squared is 30%. I have a general rule that if it's less than 50%, don't keep it. By the way, usually these things that pop up in Minitab have a lot of great information if you just sort of hover over the right area. And then the last example I was going to give you real quick is my ad agencies have been running some ads. This is the new one, Omega. This is the positive response and negative. So they ran an all male ad, then they ran an all female ad. And it looks visually to me that the co-ed ad is doing much better. Discrete, 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 discrete. Everything's discrete. Neither one's really a Y or an X, but if you go to the roadmap, and we've got discrete, discrete right here, and I'm going to do the hypothesis that they're not associated. Basically, to state it correctly, there's no association between the positive and negative and the type of ad we ran. So let's see. That would be under, it tells me to go to stat, tables, chi-squared test of association. I have it already set up. I like to use, if you do pivot tables, that's pretty much the drop down you would use. So I'll put in the three ads, and I just need to go tell it to give me the chi-square statistic so I can see. All right, the null hypothesis is nothing's going on. Here's another cool feature with Minitab. If you click on it and click help, it'll take you right to a summary of everything that you wanted to know about this. Just any one of these corners has it. It's an amazing software in terms of learning statistics. So the p-value is less than 0.05, and I simply, this third row is your chi-squared critical value, and the biggest number, there it is, that's where the bias is. 22 people did not like the ad. It should have been 40 if there was no association between these and the positive negative rate. So it looks like the co-ed ad really worked, and maybe that's why Omega has higher sales. You know, I'm making these examples up as we go, but I just wanted you to see that. Lastly, I wasn't sure if I had shown you time series plots in Minitab. So very quickly, the buzzword is special cause variation, non-random, and you can do control charts or you can do a run chart. And again, I would have gotten there by being down in this section. I'm only looking at a Y. The data is in time order, so I can click on that. Takes me right to it. I also have set up a link, for example, for the Pareto chart. Just go right there and it'll hook you up. So every day I measure 5 pins to see how long they are as part of my sampling strategy. And I just want to see if the vendor providing me these pins, I'm using the example of like a cotter pin that's holding a very important piece of equipment together. So assistant, control charts, and it is subgroup size less than 8, so it's an X bar. Look, there's another cool thing about Minitab. If you click on this, it'll give you an example if you can't figure it out. So I'm going to do the X bar R. My data is pin length. My subgroup size is 5. I'm going to ask Minitab to draw the control limits. Nothing popped up, so I'm assuming this process is stable. And the answer is yes, the process is stable and in control. So anyway, I just wanted to give you a quick little video of doing the analyze phase of DMAIC in Minitab. I already showed you how to do the measure phase, and I'll be doing more when I do some project examples. So you'll get a hold of this, and look forward to talking to you in another module.